worry, I worry, said her father.
Worry, 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 too much worry,
said her grandmother.
Pet old Mumbly Wood about the tree in the front yard and the bug in the living room wall and the noise the radiators made.
At the playground, Mumbly Wood about the chains on the swings, in the bus on the slide, in the cars on the jungle gym. And she always worried about the dog pet.
Don't worry, said her mother.
Don't worry,
said her father.
But Mumbly Wood.
Especially worried, she rubbed and petted his ears. Mumbly worried that if she did something, Petal would have no ears left at all. On her birthday, Mumbly worried that no one would come to her party.
See, there's nothing to worry about, said her mother, but then Mumbly worried that there wouldn't be enough cake.
On Halloween, Mumbly worried that there would be too many butterflies in the neighborhood party.
See, there was nothing to worry about,
said her father, but then Mumbly worried because she was the only one.
You worry too.
Said her mother.
When you worry, I worry.
Said her father.
Worry, worry, worry. Too much worry.
Said her grandmother.
Soon Mumbly had a new worry school. I'm really worried about the start of school. More than anything she had ever worried about before. By the time the first day arrived, Wembley had a long list of worries.
What if no one else wears spots? What if no one else wears stripes? What if no one else brings a doll? What if the teacher is mean? What if the room smells bad? What if they make fun of my name? What if I can't find the bathroom? What if I hit the snack? What if I had to cry?
Don't worry,
said her mother.
Don't worry,
said her father. But Wembley would. She would and would and would. She would all the way there.
Well, Wembley's parents talked to the teacher and Mrs. Peachum. Wembley looked around at the room. Then Mrs. Peachum said,
Wembley, there is someone I think you should meet.
But I want to do. She was standing by herself. She was wearing a stripe. She was holding a doll.
At first, Wembley and Jewel just peeked at each other.
This is Petal,
said Wembley.
This is Niblet, said Jewel.
Petal waved, Niblet waved back.
Hi, said Petal.
Hi,
said Niblet.
I rub her ears,
said Wembley.
I rub her nose,
said Jewel.
Both were moving, Wembley and Jewel sat side by side and stayed together. Whenever Petal and Niblet sat side by side too.
Wembley worried, but no more than usual. It's just a mess. Before Wembley knew it, it was time to go home.
Come back tomorrow, called Mrs. Peachum. As the students walked out the door, Wembley turned and smiled and waved.